So can black seeds actually cure HIV in people? At first glance, you might say, no way in the world is this possible. But I will tell you, there is research on this. And if you look at the results of those research studies, they're kind of impressive. So I want to take this time to not only show you the research on black seeds and HIV in people, we're going to leave out the rat studies for this time, and I want to show you the results of those studies, how much of the black seeds have been used in clinical research, give you an idea of how to maybe mix this up for yourself if you want to, and also share with you my thoughts on the studies because I have read them and I do have opinions on these studies. So my hope is that this video will basically save you some time and effort if you are looking at trying this for yourself. And right up front, before we go any further, I want you to know I don't work for Big Pharma. I don't work for anybody selling black seeds. I'm just a guy out there who is trying to make a difference in the lives of other people. So let's now begin our discussion by looking at what I believe is the very first study on black seeds and HIV in human beings. It comes out in the year 2013. It's basically titled Nigella sativa concoction causes sustained seroreversion in an HIV patient. Seroreversion is fancy talk for they could not find any signs of the HIV virus in an individual. So this investigation involves one individual. He's a 46-year-old guy in Nigeria. Nonetheless, the results of this paper are impressive. So he's got HIV. He's showing signs of AIDS. He's got fever. He's got sores in his body, fatigue, diarrhea, etc. And he's not taking any HIV medications whatsoever. So it's stated in the paper that there's an herbalist, and the herbalist puts together a concoction, and that's the word they use, a concoction of black seeds and honey. And they prescribe that this guy takes 10 milliliters of the Nigella sativa black seed concoction 3 times a day. In other words, 2 teaspoons of this 3 times a day. And what's interesting about this study when I read it is that he basically said, I don't have the time to take it 3 times a day because I work 12-hour days. I can only take it twice a day. And he continued to take it twice a day for 6 months. So what happened? So it's reported in this paper that within 1 week of starting this black seed therapy, it's reported that his fatigue and his fever and his diarrhea started to go away. Within 20 days, the sores on his body begin to disappear. And after 2 months, his CD4 white blood cell count, which is normally decimated by the HIV virus, begins to increase. And his viral load becomes undetectable. They cannot find the signs of the HIV virus in this individual. After 6 months of doing this therapy, it is further stated that medical tests could not find any signs of HIV in his body. Here's a table that they show in the paper where you can get an idea that for the first 5 months, he's basically HIV positive, but after that, he is regarded as being HIV negative. And 4 years later, when they check back with him, he's still HIV negative. In fact, in the paper, they actually call him the ex-HIV patient. So pretty impressive results, but I will point out again, I have a few questions about this study. Number one, it wasn't really a quote-unquote clinical study. It was more of a case report of a single individual. I also wondered what was the name of the herbalist that was used in this paper. The name of the herbalist, I am not sure of. It wasn't mentioned. Also, what type of black seeds were they using in this paper? They don't say. However, keep watching because I'm going to circle back and talk more about this later in the video. Now, as for this concoction of black seeds, how much did they use? It was a 60-40 combination of black seeds and honey. Again, keep watching because I'm going to talk more about this concoction later on in the video. Now let's move on to another paper, which also came out in 2013. It's titled The Effectiveness of an Herbal Remedy in 6 HIV-Positive Patients in Nigeria. So as the title states, this is an investigation involving 6 people. They have HIV and they are in advanced stages of the disease. These people were diagnosed with HIV. However, they agreed to only use black seed therapy during the course of this investigation, which, by the way, in this paper, they're no longer calling it a concoction. They're calling it by something else, AlphaZam. So if you're doing this research for yourself and you come across AlphaZam, that's the same thing as the black seed and honey concoction. And let me state again, these people were not using HIV medications during the course of this investigation. So what happened? So I'm going to quote directly from the researchers themselves in this paper when they state, the symptoms and signs associated with HIV infection disappeared within 20 days of commencement of the herbal therapy. 20 days, they started to get better. Here's a table that they show within this paper that gives an idea of how long it took for various signs and symptoms to start getting better after they began this black seed honey therapy. From this table, we can see that things like fevers, coughs, and skin rashes were cleared up after between 11 and 21 days. And for those wondering, the skin rashes, they took the longest before they started to get better. Here's another table they show of their CD4 white blood cell counts and how they increased during the treatment with black seeds. As you can see from this column here, they started with CD4 counts in the low 200s and less, and after 17 weeks, their CD4 counts basically tripled into the 600 and 700s. And the average increase in CD4 cell counts was 454 cells per microliter. And for the scientists watching me, I will point out that for the most part, these increases were deemed to be clinically significant. This table also shows how their body weights changed as well. Let's look at this table a little better. As you can see here, their body weights range from around 97 pounds to 132 pounds, and some people had their body weights increase between 110 and 165 pounds. I will point out, however, that the average weight gain in this study was 24 pounds or 12 kilograms. So in other words, these people are also gaining weight from using this black seed and honey concoction therapy. Now I want to show you what I feel is the largest study to date on black seeds and HIV. It comes out in 2011, it involves 51 individuals, men and women, and these are people who have HIV. They complete 5 months of this black seed honey therapy. And I will also point out that of these 51 people, six of them were also taking HIV medication at the same time. Again, I'm going to quote directly from the researchers in this paper when they say that signs and symptoms of HIV infection in all of the people fully subsided within 3 weeks of using the black seed and honey concoction. Here are the CD4 white blood cell counts for those who had stage 3 HIV infection. As you can see from this table, their CD4 white blood cell counts increased from the pre-treatment stage to the post-treatment stage, and for the most part, their viral loads decreased to undetectable levels. Now, if we move on to those people who had stage 4 HIV infection, which is the worst stage to have, we see that their CD4 counts also increased, and for the most part, their HIV viral load was undetectable. So that's the largest study so far, pretty impressive, but we're not done yet. I have one more paper to call your attention to. This one comes out in 2015 and is titled Seronegative Conversion of an HIV Positive Subject Treated with Nigella Sativa and Honey. So in this paper, we have a single individual. She's a 27-year-old pregnant woman. She has HIV, but she's not yet showing symptoms. She uses the black seed and honey combination each day as prescribed for 1 full year, and she started using it in her third trimester of pregnancy. Now, they monitored this woman weekly until she gave birth, and then they continued to monitor her monthly for up to 2 years, and then they continued their monitoring of her every 6 months for a full 10 years. If we look at her CD4 count and her viral load, we can see that she's HIV positive for the first 6 months of taking black seeds and honey. And after 1 year, and then for the following 9 years, they indicate she's HIV negative. Oh, and by the way, she gave birth to other children as well. She breastfed them, and the kids were not infected. Okay, so these papers on the surface are really impressive, but I must point out to you that I have read these papers and I have some questions about them that, quite frankly, you should be asking yourself as well. Number one, who were the herbalists that made up this black seed honey concoction? I could not find the name of the herbalist mentioned in any of these papers. You'd think that anybody who is able to cure this disease would be shouting it from the rooftops. I also want to call your attention to, in one of the papers, as a matter of fact, the one that came out in 2015, they talk about what's called non-disclosed components of the black seed and honey concoction that act to release the active constituents of black seeds in the body. Okay, what are those non-disclosed components? Black seeds have an awful lot of compounds in them, but nowhere in any of these papers did I see mention of what these non-disclosed components were that were so critical to the functioning of this black seed honey concoction. Why hasn't anybody taken this into the lab and analyzed it to find out what its full composition is? Now, the last study I found on this was from the year 2015. That's a long time ago. Where are the other clinical trials? You'd think that Big Pharma would be all over this. So where are the giant studies involving thousands of people with placebo-controlled clinical trials? I haven't found any. Oh, and by the way, I don't buy the argument that you can't patent a natural substance. Yes, you can. Many pharmaceutical drugs have been derived from natural medicines. Here's just a quick summary of a few of the medications that originally came from natural compounds. Another thing I noticed after reading these research studies is that all of them have been conducted by the same two primary researchers. Now, there's nothing wrong with this, but why hasn't anybody else attempted to replicate these findings? Okay, so you're probably wondering, what's up with this black seed honey concoction? How do you make it? Well, as I mentioned earlier, it's a 60%, 40% combination of black seeds and honey. And I will again point out that the scientific name for black seeds is Nigella sativa. So you can go searching online or in local shops for either one of those words and you'll be able to find it. So this means that 60% of the mixture comes from black seeds and 40% comes from honey. And I will also point out that we're talking about black seeds themselves and not black seed oil. None of the research I saw used black seed oil. So in one of the papers I saw on this, they described making the concoction of black seeds and honey with 6 kilograms or 12 pounds of dried Nigella sativa seeds, black seeds, purchased from a local market in Kano, which is in the northern part of Nigeria. The seeds were ground into a fine powder with a mortar and a pestle, and they were mixed with 4 liters or 135 ounces of freshly harvested pure honey. They didn't mention a specific brand of honey. They just simply said freshly harvested and pure, and they left it at that. This paste that they created was stored for later use and given to people, and they were told to use 30 milliliters, or about 1 ounce, 3 times a day. In other words, that's 10 milliliters, or about 0.34 ounces, or about 2 teaspoons, 3 times a day. Another paper I saw, they said that they mixed the black seeds and honey with warm distilled water, and again, they used that 3 times a day. So in other words, distilled water, not tap water. And I do think that they used warm water to help the black seeds and honey dissolve better and make it more easily to be taken. They didn't mention anything about the temperature of the water, only that it was warm water. So I don't think the temperature actually matters much. Here's a summary that I put together of the amounts of the black seeds and honey used in the different papers that I showed you so that you can see that the recommended dosage is the same between these 4 studies. Okay, so I threw an awful lot at you in this video. I do have some thoughts on this. So number one, these research papers that I showed you, if they are to be believed, they appear to show that a 60-40 combination of black seeds and honey is all that is necessary. In other words, you don't need to mix it with coconut water. You don't need to have anybody bless the water or the concoction. You don't need to use any special water that comes from a certain part of the world. Distilled water is all I saw mentioned. I bring this up because if black seeds and honey really do work for HIV infection, that tells us this is a pretty inexpensive cure. So in other words, don't fall for expensive cures peddled by people you don't know on the internet, because I know they're out there. In fact, once they see this video, I'm pretty sure some of them are going to try to post links to their supposed cures in the comments, and I'm not going to let that happen. Another thing I want to call your attention to is they don't specify whether the black seeds are organic, and they don't mention any specific brand of black seeds either. Although fresh Nigella sativa seeds would probably be preferable over those that have been laying around for 6 months or a year. So if you're trying this, check the expiration date on the products you buy. And again, the same thing with honey. They don't mention a specific brand of honey. They don't say whether it's organic. They only say that it's pure and freshly harvested. And that goes again to some of my questions with these papers. I've read thousands of papers over the years, and when I read these papers, there are things that I want to see that I do not see. And that makes me skeptical of these claims. That's another reason why I want to see somebody pick up the mantle and do a much better clinical trial to see if black seeds really do help HIV infection. And by better, I mean randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled clinical trials. That is the best type of clinical trial you can do. And right now, we don't have that information. If this video helped you, please share it with your friends so it can continue to help other people. And if you have tried black seeds for your HIV, please leave a comment below and let me know what happened. And until next time, please take care out there.